all set?
God keep our land.
Glorious
and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard.
They are ready for the final of the World Cup of Hockey, and make no mistake about it, in the back of the minds of all of these people is, when is the next hockey game we'll see with NHL players in it? Yes, this matters. This game is what the players will concentrate on, but for the fans in the seats, especially here in Canada and in Finland, where it's 2 o'clock in the morning and there will be millions watching this game, this is about winning this World Cup, which really in the United States, we don't have a real good feel for. It is, however, like Lord Stanley's Cup. Let's check in with Aaron.
Well, Gary, Team Finland netminder Miikka Kiprusoff told me he is not worried about the three Tampa Bay Lightning players on Team Canada. He said the Stanley Cup final has no bearing on tonight's game. He said he doesn't even worry about his own Calgary teammate, Jerome Iginla. He told me, quote unquote, I owned Jerome in practice. But Gary, I asked Jerome about that, and he said, don't believe what Kiprusoff will tell you. I scored 7 out of 10 times on him in practice. Guys, believe who you want. We'll see who wins it tonight.
We are underway. Martin takes the face off. It'll be Team Canada in red, the white and blue for Team Finland. Niedermayer and Regier out there defensively. Tamu Salani in a big hitting line, and there's our first hit. Teppo Neumann puts it on. Same scratches for Team Canada with Brett Marlowe and Jovanovski out of the lineup, along with Jose Theodore. In the lineup is Marty Brodeur.
Back in is Marty Brodeur after missing the last game with a bad left wrist. Roberto Luongo was able to advance Team Canada to this championship game, but Marty Brodeur is their bread and butter man in goal. Canada is deep in every position. There is Luongo backing up. You can only play one goalie at a time, though. And Brodeur is clearly their money man in the pipes.
As Barry noted, these two teams, defensively and offensively, are virtually identical here in this World Cup play. 15 goals for Finland, 19 Team Canada. Each has given up 6. Their power plays have been more or less effective, more so than not. Penalty killing, both teams have done well. So they do match up. Team Canada unquestionably has the greater depth, while the speed and the hope for physical play is what Finland would like to use in this game. Salo along the near side wall. Mario Lemieux's line is out there, held in by Brewer along the near side. Dumped back into the middle on the intercept and cleared out of the zone by Olli Jokinen. It'll be out of foot going back.
I think it's really important that Finland tries to get off to a real quiet start. They need to take the crowd out. The crowd's going to be really, really excited to start this game. And
look,
so
look at Mario. Mario got that pass into the...
Not saying in the beginning of the telecast that he is going to show why he's one of the best players ever to play. Well, watch this pass that he makes. Bill, this is unbelievable. He's a righty, and he makes a pass across his body.
Yeah, I'm more impressed with how he picked up the pass from Sakic.
Oh,
look
my
at the move
God.
Outside the blue line. You better clear off a spot on the museum wall. That play right there was a piece of art, and it belongs somewhere in the archives of World Cup of Hockey history. What a play for Canada to go on top 1-0.
And I tell you, if he's going to put it on the stick of anybody, that kid that he just put it on the stick, Jerome Iginla, one of the best scorers in the National Hockey League for the last 2 years.
Team Canada in the first minute gets a 1-0 lead. They could not have hoped for anything better than that. And for Finland, they could not have hoped for anything worse. Barton behind the net, gets it out in front, gets kicked away into the middle. Finland wants this to be a low scoring, grind it out, little number shots game. Team Canada wants to run and gun. Played back by Teppo Neumann. Thornton out there with his line as the Team Canada here in the second round has kept their lines together for the most part throughout these games, and why not with the success they've had. The goal at 52 seconds. It'll be Sakic announced from Lemieux and Brewer. Sakic from Lemieux and Brewer on the goal to make it 1-0. On the near side, Lord Hetsinen.
So much for them taking the crowd out of the play.
Yeah, you got that part right.
Jeez.
That went into the middle. And Marty Brodeur 2 minutes. Lemieux, Sakic, and a Gintlev scored a goal, and Marty Brodeur's made a great save.
And that means the key ingredients are on board already. We talked about Marty Brodeur, JR. You called him the most consistent goalie the last 10 years in the NHL. But besides the consistency, what he has brought is the ability to come up with huge saves at major times in a hockey game. And believe me, that was a major time, even though we're early in the first period.
That prevented Finland from getting back in and feeling a lot better about itself. Hit put on by Riku Hahl on the near side, who plays for Colorado. Physical aspect of Finland's game is something to look for early. Alaranta could not hold that one in. It came outside the line. How much does it matter to score first in this World Cup of Hockey? 16-1-1. When you do, Finland defeated the Team USA 2-1 in their game. Mario got a great assist.
Oh, gracious. Gosh. And JR, you and I were talking about Mario's size, especially against some of the smaller Finnish defensemen like Tiemannin, like Teppo Numminen. We talked about his reach. I think it was Tony Lidman that stepped up on him to try to intercept that pass. It was all reach to start that play in the neutral zone.
I'll tell you what Mario brings that people don't see is his touch. He has, for a big man, he has tremendous touch. His hands are great. He makes deft passes. When you don't think the puck can get there, he finds a way to get it there. Underneath sticks, lofted little saucers over. This guy, he can find anybody from anywhere on the rink. He's just incredible. He's incredible to watch.
Said to Mario at the start of the game, the question about whether this, it is 16 NHL seasons done, would be his last game remains an issue. He wants to play a couple more years, but the lockout that'll be announced tomorrow in New York, if it goes for a long time, this could be Mario Lemieux's last game. And he acknowledged that when we talked with him on the bench tonight. Regier off on the near side, played it up the wall, intended for Draper. Got cut short, dumped back in, Doan, shot wide. Right off the wall, Doan had the opportunity as Thornton dumped that one in. Back with speed, Koivo left it down low, Teemu Selanne. This is their big scoring line, the Selanne and Koivo together.
What a back check by Joe Thornton of the Boston Bruins. That was on the tape of Selanne, except for the reach of Thornton.
Lehtinen, Koivo, and Selanne on their line have scored 12 points. They are the leading line for Finland so far in World Cup action. And we are in the World Cup final. Cleared around the boards by Tiemannin. Tiemannin, number four, leads all defensemen in scoring. There he handles the puck. He's been magnificent. Shot on, got blocked up into the screen. Hagman with the opportunity.
And it's so important for Team Canada to back check, because as we just saw in one play, Tiemannin jumped up on it. This was the play earlier with Selanne at the bottom of your screen. He was, I mean, that was right there. Koivu had him tape to tape, except for Joe Thornton's back check. Such an underrated part of the game. You don't get any publicity for it. You seldom get paid for it. You just win hockey games because of it.
And a great job done there. Team Canada, their coach, Pat Quinn, saying this morning he knew the physical play and the speed of Finland would be the two things they'd have to get to first, and one of the ways to get to it was scoring early. They have done that. They hope that will force Finland to open it up a little bit and skate more their kind of game.
But if any team's going to stick to the game plan, I think it's Finland. I mean, I know you want to open a team up, but this is like a machine that's full of emotion, but they cloak their emotion. They seldom change the way they play regardless of the score.
I'm telling you what, they can't change their game, because they're going to have a team like Canada that's just going to keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. This game is so important to the people of Canada. It's almost like the Super Bowl. All around town, they have the film festival in here. Nobody cares about the film festival. This is Canada Cup hockey, boys and girls. This is everything in Canada. These people are excited.
Baltimore Orioles were sitting around the lobby of our hotel today, and I saw Rafael Palmeiro. That one wide. I said, Rafi, aren't you going to play tonight? He says, you kidding? You got a hockey game here tonight. We're going to have to sit and watch and wait for tomorrow. That's what it's like here. Cleared back over to Brewer. Brewer foot out there defensively. Adam Foote has been his usual spectacular play. Great pass, shot. That got blocked into the corner. What a play by Aki Berg. The net comes off on the driving chance, and a good chance for Martin St. Louis.
And he got the puck first. Excellent defensive play. But this is unlike Finland. If Canada is finding seams for passes like this right away, it does not augur well for Team Finland. Super long pass by Brad Richards that found St. Louis. But look at the defensive play by Aki Berg. He got a knock on the helmet for his effort, but he got the puck first, and that's why there was no call. If you miss the puck and get the legs, you're gone.
Kiprusoff has seen enough of these guys. St. Louis and Brad Richards scored 4 goals each against Kiprusoff in the Stanley Cup Finals just 99 days ago. And now they are out there together on the same line. They played for Tampa Bay, of course, in winning the Cup in June. Held on to into the corner by Ruutu, left it down low, got bumped on the shot. shot. Ilkinen had the opportunity, but he never got it on net. It was played back. Teppo Numanen. Numanen leaves it into the middle. Ruutu. Ruutu trying to dump it ahead. Sakic got a piece of that. Sakic, Lemieux back out with Aginla on their line. Kiprusoff held it up. Aginla tried to knock it down. Aginla did and got it back. 1-0. Team Canada leading in. Shot. That one blocked into the corner by Timonen. Timonen puts the hit on. Another charge made by Joe Sakic. 16th all time in NHL points. Sakic out there, 91, hitting to the front of the net. Again, we're looking for it. Again, with a Lemieux. Lemieux working in the corner. This team controlling the puck. Back on top. Again, we're trying to go through. Picked back up by Sakic. Lemieux cutting. Saved by Kiprusoff. And Lemieux got that shot off with a stick in his jersey up his back.
I'll tell you what.
But no load is too heavy or too big for Mario to carry when there's a scoring chance at stake. Look at him come into the net.
I mean, tell you what, Mario Lemieux is one of the best in the world, but I don't care how good you are to make a play like that with a guy like Teppo Numanen on your back, with a stick in your shirt, making a baseball bat swing with the puck coming from behind you and almost scoring. Are you kidding?
His jersey's now too big to wear. He had it stretched about three sizes on that one. Drop back to Regier. Off the near side, Draper as they clear the zone. Dumped in a little wide. Thornton giving chase behind the net. Vananen. Ozzie Vananen, outstanding defensive player. Tip back to center. Not only does Team Canada have the 1-0 lead, territorially, they look pretty good.
But you see what they're doing too, Gary. They're dumping the puck in deep. Mario Lemieux did it to start that last shift. Joel Thornton just did it. Look what Canada's doing now.
This is a grind line for Team Canada. Doan left it on the near side. Draper's back there with Thornton behind the net. Thornton looking in front. Thornton trying to muscle it. Tremendous size. Thornton to the Boston Bruins. Controlling the puck. Just cannot get it away from him. Salo up the near side. Koivu could move it to Solani. Dumped back into the middle. Salo lost it. Thornton the pickup. Leaves it down low. Doan looking. Shot. Save by Kiprusoff. Rebound on Kiprusoff. Stick. And twice he had to knock it away. Ping pong game. Brodeur leaves it in the corner. And right now, Finland needs to get it out of there. They need a line change. Team Canada's changing up behind the play. Shot, save, hit, bounced away. Brodeur had the chance. Vinny LeCavalier cutting in, almost got it. Fireside Lehtinen out of legs.
And Kiprusoff, the way Canada's driving the net, it better not leave any rebounds out in front like that.
4-3, the shots in favor of Team Canada right now. Brodeur to knock that shot away from Hahl on the point. Sent back up on top. Riku Hahl winding up that one. Brodeur scores! Deflected Tony Lehtinen out of the blue line. It bounced off someone and went in. And it's tied at one.
What a break for Finland. This is exactly what the doctor ordered. And not a pretty goal, but all they do is just get the puck to the net. That's what they stress in the National Hockey League these days, because you never know. It's going to go off a stick, go off a foot. But just get it on the net. Let some guys go to the net, create a little screen. And Marty, he always struck. Oh, what a great tip. We didn't even see that from up here. That's what happens. You get guys going to net, get the puck on net, and what a good relief for the Finnish to be in this game now, 1-1.
Said it when they played Team USA. I'll say it again. You will not break the spirit or the will of Team Finland, regardless of how you play them.
They stayed with it, and they got it. They've had a couple of chances by dumping it from the blue line. Here's another, and Brodeur, that one deflect up and over on a Teppo Numanen and hard blast. And this game is tied at one. That is an enormous goal to get in the first 10 minutes of this period after Team Canada scored in the first minute of this game. They can behind the net. Simon Gagné dropped it off into the corner. Gagné out there. Brad Richards, St. Louis, held it off the far side by Hagman. Hagman got it out of there. Hagman back into this lineup. And Billy Niemann, a real disturber on the ice, is not playing in this game. Aki Berg went back to get it. And in Finland, you may have heard a roar wherever you're sitting watching this game from Finland. Lemieux centered it. Again, a deflected shot into the glove of Kiprusoff. And again, a great setup by Mario Lemieux. We are tied at 1-1, the final of the World Cup of Hockey. Canada the favorite, their brain trust with Gretzky on the goal.
Gretzky on the right in shirt sleeves is the architect of Team Canada. And there's not much of a chance to really let off steam or let your emotions out. This was Saturday night when Canada took a 3-2 lead against the Czech Republic, only to see it vanish later. The ups and downs of a man that constructed a team. The final emotion was positive on Saturday, and that's why Team Canada is here tonight.
Thornton wins the draw along the near side, intended for Doan. The goal has been credited to Elorada from Lidman and Berg, but Elorada was not the man who touched it. Here's Solani trying to move it in. The goal coming at 6:34 to tie it up. Team Finland doing battle down low, and this is where they can get real tough. Cleared around the boards off the far side by Scott Niedermayer. Not out of the by Regier, though. Regier has actually taken a couple of hits instead of just giving them. Bounces into the corner.
I think this is a good matchup that Canada wanted. They want some physical players against this very, very high, talented line of Koivu and Solani. I'll tell you what, Shane Doan is going to really throw the body around a lot and frustrate the Solani and Koivu and not let them have any time.
Well, this is the way Team Canada started, too. This is a matchup it looks like Pat Quinn wants, with Joe Thornton in the middle, with Doan and Draper on either side against the Koivu-Solani.
Sakic on the tic-tac, got it again with a shot. That got deflected up and into the netting as Tuomo Ruutu blocked it. Want to remind you, tomorrow the Hunt for October continues, a special ESPN day game. Rodriguez, Jeter, and the Yankees take on the Kansas City Royals. It'll start tomorrow at 2 Eastern. ESPN will have it.
Pat Quinn's team is the home team. Why? Because of a coin toss. They had to decide who was going to be home. Why is that important? Well, it worked against Canada because they had to wear their dark reds, which is home version in the NHL. They wanted to wear their whites. But they get last change, and if they plan on matching, that can be important in this game.
See that checking game going on by Finland to free the puck up. Sakic came back to help out, though. It'll be moved back through the middle by Brodeur. Nowhere to go, and there you see Finland. If they cannot send two forecheckers in and do it that way, they will drop back into a 1-2-2 or a 2-3 and hook it up.
But they'll press you, too. Yeah. It's not a passive retreat 2-3. The front two guys are on the chase. They're buzzing you all the time.
Ruutu Hahl had a poke checked away from him. Le Cavalier on the far side lost it. Team Canada gets it back. Good check by Le Cavalier. Again, Lowe's getting held over there by Ruutu as they both try and enter the bench. That one comes around the boards and out of the zone. It will be whistled. Jerome Iginla, the high-flying first line for Team Canada.
Jerome Iginla, just the ultimate true professional. Probably one of the nicest guys, I think, in the National Hockey League. You see him, he's always got a smile, always got a hello for you and a good handshake. And this kid can put the puck in the net, and he'll fight anybody in the league. That's how tough this kid is.
But the way Mario Lemieux has started, I think Jerome Iginla needs to focus on one thing. Put your nose down and drive the paint. It will get there.
Keep your stick on the ice.
Yeah.
Mario will find us up here in the booth if we yell loud enough.
Just yell. Tony Lidman able to hold that in. Team Canada having some problems moving out of the zone. Ryan Smith got it into the middle. Aki Berg stood it up. Smith got it back, sends it in. Bumping and grinding going on away from the play. We've not had a penalty here in the first period. Game is tied at one apiece. The shots are even at 5-5, and that's pretty much the way it's been played. Vinny Le Cavalier, second in the scoring in this World Cup action. He's been magnificent with two game-winning goals, including the overtime game winner that brought them into the finals. Line changes into the middle, roll through. Kiprusoff had to knock it away. Martin St. Louis was cutting through but couldn't get a stick on it. Regier, he'll be beat to the puck by Huntanen. Huntanen takes the hit from Regier, and I mean a hard one in touch for the icing.
Jerome Iginla can lead the National Hockey League in many categories, including the number of middle names that he has. Full name, Jerome Arthur Lee out of Quinlay Teague Jr. Elvis Iginla. Starting catcher for the 1992 Canadian National Junior Team, an incredible all-around athlete. And as you mentioned, JR, one of the nicest humans on this planet Earth.
Brad Richards on the faceoff. The 239s went at it right there. Nico Kapanen won that draw. Kapanen, who played for Dallas last year, swings that one away, but not out of the zone. Vanenen got it up along the boards. Team Canada will get it back. 1-1 game. We're more than midway through this first period. We will be joined during our first intermission by the two parties involved in the collective bargaining agreements. The men who have been at the table, Ben Saskin and Bill Daly, will be on board. We'll see if we can find anything out. Tomorrow's the day when the contract CBA expires. They've already scheduled a news conference in New York tomorrow afternoon for the announcement of a lockout. That one bumped off the fireside boards and cleared. Gary Lehtinen got it out of there. Finland will change it up. Played back to Brodeur. Brodeur, he's looking to see persons off the bench, and the person of Thornton right there sends it in deep. Tiemannin will come back to get it, touches that one up, and that will be whistled. This is the final of the World Cup of Hockey, 1-1.
Welcome back to Toronto, and these are the good seats. This seat I'm in right now is the single heftiest ticket price you will pay in all of Toronto sports history. here tonight, guys. And by the way, walking in, I talked to a few scalpers, $1,200 to get into the game tonight. This place was sold out 3 weeks ago, people anticipating Canada being in the final, guys.
Thanks. Brewer cleared it around the boards. Where'd she come up with that one? That one got knocked away. Teemu Selänne. Selänne moving it in, got tripped up. Adam Foot got a stick in. Thornton clears that one back out to center. In the history of World Cup play, Canada-Finland have met four times. Canada has won three of those games and one tie. Finland trying to do what they've never done before, knock off Canada in a World Cup final. This will be chased down by Temminen, and we'll touch it up for the ice.
This is exactly how Finland wants this game to go right now. They're slowing it up. They're taking the crowd out of it. Now everybody's sitting on their hands, wondering what's going on. A little chess match going on. This plays right into Finland's game. They can make it quiet and hopefully lull the Canadians to sleep.
One of the symptoms to watch for, and there's their head coach, Raimo Schumann. Last 3 minutes, Canada's iced the puck three different times. That means that the Finnish team is pressing. That means that Canada has not been able to get the red line when they wanted to. That means that Finland has torqued it up. That boa constrictor defense that tries to suffocate you and wait for your mistakes.
That'll be cleared in. Lemieux's line back out there with a Gitla Joe Sakic, played by Aki Berg. Five-man units primarily for Finland. Clearly they want Aki Berg out there defensively. Off the near side, it'll be sent back in against his first line for Team Canada along with Tony Lindman. There is Berg, and he's been out there, plays here in Toronto.
He's the only player in this game that plays for the Toronto Maple Leafs. He got an assist on the goal by Finland. Booed the hell out of him. It ain't about the Toronto Maple Leafs right now. It's about nationalism. It's about Canada, and it's about Finland.
Aki Berg, Toronto fans, well acquainted. That one gets a bounce back deep off the faceoff win by Jokinen. Jokinen, who plays for Florida, got it back to Salo. Salo starts up. Good forechecking. Danny Heatley had moved into the zone that time. Marty Brodeur moves out. Look out. Brodeur didn't play that one well. He had Ruutu coming in on him. Shot back around the near side. Tuomo Ruutu that time got a piece of it. Gary Lettinen dumps it back in behind the net. Niedermayer overskated it. Ruutu's got it again. Can't get it out in front, though. Team Canada will finally just clear to take the heat off. And it will be touched up for the icing. And you're right, Bill. It's now Finland doing what they want. Want to remind you, tomorrow, the Wednesday night doubleheader, Bank One presents at 8 Eastern. Carlos Beltran, the Astros, an amazing run against Albert Pujols and an amazing Cardinals season. At 10 Eastern, Adrian Beltre, the Dodgers, looking to extend their lead against the Padres. Tomorrow, doubleheader, ESPN Baseball.
I know Pat Quinn does not want to shorten his bench just yet, but by the way Mario Lemieux started this game, you got to know if there's any extra ice time to go around. He's the guy that needs it.
Joe Sakic won another faceoff for Team Canada. Into the corner, stick again up into a Ginla's jersey that time. A Ginla, Sakic over to help him out. Sakic being dragged around by Kapanen. Back up onto the point, down deep, intended for Lemieux. Great, couldn't be held in there. Lemieux now dumps it back in behind the net. Moved away by Kapanen and out of the zone. Team Canada at center. Baumeister reached, didn't get it. And that one deflected wide of the net. Nico Kapanen, who can fly, had a little room in the middle, chose to take the shot deep. Sakic from behind the net will leave it. Baumeister will move it up. 7 minutes to go, first period, game tied. Shots are 6-5 in favor of Canada. Into the corner, it was Koivu. Saku Koivu got through the Hodgkin's disease problem a couple of years ago to come back and play for the Canadiens. Now playing here for Finland. Intercept, Lettinen centered. Block, shot, deflected back up to the top. Held back in by Salo. Salo got a deep. Brewer held up by Selänne. Lettinen moved in, a hit on foot. Koivu on the far side and Doan. They do battle along the wall. Off the dasher, Thornton was able to bang it out. Sammy Salo came back to get it. Vancouver, where he played last year, put ahead to Doan. They want a line change here, and it'll be shipped in by Thornton to get it.
One thing that the Finns really do so well, and you can watch, is they support each other really well. They're very close to each other, short little passes. The long passes are a very low percentage, but they're always right next to each other. The little chip passes, give and goes, it gives them an opportunity to get in and break open for a good shot on net.
Yeah, they don't want to play a one-on-one game. I mean, when you don't support, you leave your teammate to battle it out one-on-one.
They seem to be the best at doing it. There's always someone right next to them, almost within an arm's reach, and they communicate very well, always talking down there.
Finland finished fifth in the World Cup in 96. That was won by the U.S. in an upset of Canada. They were tied for fifth in the Olympics in Salt Lake. Did not take a medal there. Now, Finland gets a chance to wipe all of that slate clean if they can win this final game of the World Cup of Hockey, something they've never done before. Back into the corner, Berg putting the pressure hold on. Puck free back up, though. Simon Gagné. Gagné takes the hit. Lidman over there on him. Boy, there's some banging going on now. Down low, Brad Richards. He got taken out of the play. Finland just staying right in Team Canada's jerseys. Almost a breakaway for Alarada, but it'll be whistled on a two-liner. The final, our World Cup of Hockey from Toronto, Finland, Canada, 1-1.
On opposite sides of the international fence here for the final of the World Cup of Hockey, Wayne Gretzky, who is upstairs, and Jari Kurri behind the Finnish bench. But it wasn't that many years back that these two were one of the greatest 1-2 combinations the sport has ever seen, for the Edmonton Oilers winning Stanley Cup after Stanley Cup. Four together. Jari Kurri would go on to win a fifth without Wayne Gretzky. That's ancient history to these two guys right now.
They were magnificent. Kevin Lowe played for those Oilers, standing next to Wayne there. He's been involved in the Olympics and World Cup games as Wayne Gretzky has taken him along. Baumeister with it, sends it in off the board. You see how alive these boards are. That's Lemieux going back in behind the net, off to Aginla. Aginla leaves it. Lemieux around. Backhander got blocked inside. Aginla, he got enough on to get it in, and Kiprusoff covers it up. So if they count that, that's the first shot they've had in the last 8 minutes.
This is where, Bill, you were talking about Lemieux's size and strength and his hands, how soft his hands are. He uses strength.
Watch what he does here.
He uses strength, and he uses reach. What a great pass, first of all. Now he gets back, and he just holds off the defender,
He flipped it in the air to the front of the net so that nobody could get it with their stick on the ice.
Mario comes up with things to do with the puck that nobody else thinks of. How to get it to the front of the net, how to get it away from a defender. And he's so good at it. He looks like he's been, he's been doing it for forever. It's amazing.
Yes.
No. And he's still out there right now. Lemieux heading to the front of the net. It's dumped back in behind it, where Newman will come back to get it. Kevin Newman at 16 years in the National Hockey League. Hockey League last year with Dallas. Dumped off on the near side boards and whistled on the offside. Let's check in with David and Barry.
All right, 15 minutes in, Barry, your thoughts so far?
Don't panic. It's fine. Canada played them better in the first part of the period. Finns came on later in the period. Bottom line is, Finns are a great team. It's going to be a tough game.
All right, we'll have more in the intermission report coming your way as soon as the first period's done at the Air Canada Centre. Guys, back to you.
All right, David, thanks. And we will have Ted Saskin, Bill Daly, the negotiators at the table for each side, joining us during the first intermission for an update on where they're at. That'll be flipped in off the wall. Heatley trying to get it in, could not. Sent back. Brewer's got it. 4:42 left to go here in the period. Tied at 1-1. 7-5 shots. Canada's favor. Heatley got tied up. Dumped back to center after a wide open first 4 to 5 minutes. Finland has shut it down, playing their kind of game. Kiprusoff leaves it back in behind the net. The only two goaltenders with shutouts in this World Cup year are playing in this game, and those went by the boards. Any opportunity early in this one. Heatley's in, shot, hit the outside of the post. Heatley trying to put it off the back of Kiprusoff, but he missed.
Danny Heatley pressing for one. He has not scored yet in the World Cup. He has done a lot of tough work along the boards, but Danny Heatley has not been able to dent the twine yet.
Icing call. 4:04 left to go in the period. That gives you some idea, Bill, of just how tough it is playing at this level in these games when Heatley isn't scoring.
Well, Danny Heatley is probably one of the best young players in the National Hockey League today.
Well, watch it. Kiprusoff gets a piece of this.
Of course he does.
He scores. I mean, it went off Kiprusoff and off the post.
Of course he does. Kiprusoff seems to get a piece of every shot that comes near him.
They have changed that goal scored by Finland. Riku Hahl scores it, his first of the World Cup at 6:34. Lidman and Berg pick up the assist. Riku Hahl, the goal scorer. Back in behind the net for Draper. Taken out Thornton. Thornton, these are the black and blue out there against the top line of Finland now. There's Thornton mugging it. Doan into the middle. Doan got tied up. Back to Regier. Leaves it. Shot. Blocked. Up in the air and out to center. Good play made by Lettinen, who had the puck and had it stolen.
For the Finns to have great coverage down low and great coverage at the blue line tells you how tenacious they are.
Doan had it, lost it, rolled to center. Riku Hahl had that goal, chasing it down. That's going to be whistled. And an interference call coming, our first penalty of the game. And it's going to be on Finland. An think anybody knows it yet because nobody's made a move to head over to the box.
Steve Watkins, the man that made the call, he's pointing at somebody.
The boos are for Solani.
The team of Solani and Chris Draper started out in the corner. Got a little jostling match here, and Draper gives him a little face wash right here. And let me tell you something. Timu does not like that at all. He doesn't like the physical stuff that much, but he definitely doesn't like getting face washed. Comes back a little retaliation, hit from behind. You're always going to get retaliation calling on you.
And he does. Solani out of there. Interference, 16-38. Power play opportunity now for Team Canada. In this tie game, Team Canada's 4-for-18 on the power play. Brodeur shorthanded at a knock it away. The Finn penalty killers have given up 4 in 20 chances for the opposition. They are 5th in World Cup play of the 8 teams. Now let's see what Team Canada can do with it. Mario Lemieux will be out there, chased into the corner. And a whistle.
Icing.
Icing call.
Yep.
Wow. Denis Le Cavalier, who has picked up right where he left off in the Stanley Cup playoffs. He's been outstanding. Second leading scorer among all in the World Cup.
And he really came here with something to prove since he was a late addition. Steve Yzerman could not perform because of his facial injury, his eye injury, so Le Cavalier was called upon. And all he did from day one was set out to prove that he should have been here in the first. It's not a critical statement. It's just how deep Canada is. He wanted to prove he belongs here, and he did the first day of camp.
He has done that. Martin St. Louis got caught up on top. St. Louis, Niedermayer. Niedermayer plays it to Lemieux. Power play underway, Canada. Attempted pass into the middle, blocked and cleared out of the zone. Again, Riku Hahl is having himself a period here. 2:30 left to go in the period. 1:08 left on the power play with this game tied at 1 apiece. Niedermayer, Sakic, let it go to Lemieux. Into the middle. Can't believe how alone he was. Didn't shoot it. St. Louis working a point on the power play. Lemieux, the half boards, taken out of the play and cleared. Good work that time on Lemieux by Newman.
Great play by Newman. And that shows a veteran guy right there who knows that you cannot give Mario time on that side boards because he's going to pick everybody apart and find the open guy.
Danny Heatley put a hit on the far side. That one bounces off Richards, though. 38 seconds left to go on the advantage. Lehtinen moving up here. Lehtinen 26 and white. Brad Richards with it. Richards on the power play unit. Goal and the 3 assists in the last 4 games for Brad Richards here in the World Cup play. Centering pass blocked, shorthanded. Lehtinen, we're looking for a little help from behind, but Finland wants to change. Lehtinen will get it. Shorthanded in the middle, tied up, skated on it, fell down. Cleared back up by Thornton. 13 left on the advantage. Heatley into the zone. Heatley dropped it. Blind pass again. It wasn't there.
Dan Healy's fighting it now. He dumped the puck out blindly from behind the net that went all the way out of the zone, and he tried to make a pass there. And I could, with our specs mics, we could hear the man that he was trying to pass to yelling, no, 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 no.
No shots on the power play, and it's over. This will be an icing call with 1:15 left to go.
Danny Heatley going to suck it up and get ready for another shift. But we talked about Vincent Le Cavalier coming into his own here. This is Saturday night in overtime against the Czech Republic. An impossible angle. Well, just about an impossible angle, but Le Cavalier ended it in overtime. And he has been a key factor offensively for Team Canada. Heatley and Ryan Smith are playing the wings with Le Cavalier and aren't getting any publicity at all, but they just do all of the tough work down low.
Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Le Cavalier has scored or assisted 4 of Team Canada's 5 game-winning goals. He's had 2 of them. That'll be cleared up as we close in on the 1-minute mark of this first period. Draper touched that one up in the zone.
Billy, do you think if you asked every Finnish guy on that team if it would be tied after the first period, how many of them do you think to say, I hope so, we take that right now?
They'd all raise their hands, would they?
I think every single one of them would pay money to say, let's be tied after the first period. That's exactly where they want to be.
I agree.
These two teams have rarely ever trailed. Finland came in having trailed only 12 minutes, 7 seconds of the entire tournament. Team Canada has never trailed in any game. They have been tied for 112.44, but never behind. And they have it in this game. They got the first goal. Now it's tied up. Dump back into the corner. Draper going back. Oh, down with Timon in there with him. He gets right back up. Ouch. There they are again, fighting behind the net. Draper hanging with them. Cleared around the near side board. Solani trying to clear it out of there and did. There'll be no ice. He in front. That push by Salo as the pass came. Cleared by Ruutu up and out of the zone. Sakic scored 52 seconds. Lemieux and Brewer tied at 6:34. Hall from Lidman and Bird. And that's the way we will finish the first. Shots 9-7 in favor of Canada. So Finland's done, as JR said, what they wanted to do. They have played Team Canada even. Here's the goal by Team Canada. Gretzky celebrating a 1-0 lead, but Hall would come back at the other end. That one through Brodeur, 1-1 after one. Air Canada Center, welcome back everybody to Toronto. This is the final of the World Cup of Hockey. Finland taking on Canada. And there's Joe Sakic.
Well, Mario Lemieux and Jerome McGinn will play on the line with Joe Sakic. It's easy to, well, I shouldn't say it's easy to forget about Joe Sakic, but it's kind of, well, by the way, Joe Sakic is on this line too. He will retire as one of the 10 greatest players ever to play this sport, and I truly believe he belongs in that category.
I don't think there's a goal scorer out there with a quicker release, a more accurate release, and probably one of the best breakaway guys in the National Hockey League.
He has scored 3 goals, 2 assists, and a +3 for Joe Sakic, second only to Vinny LeCavalier and Team Canada points. Coming into this game tonight, underway in the second period. Bounce back into the corner, Shane Doan giving chase. Doan looking, Team Canada in their offensive zone here. They are in red. Finland in their blue and white. Shots 9-7 in the first in favor of Canada. Sent back Regeer in behind the net. Tried to bounce it away. Played by Doan. Lidman moved in on him. Sent through center. Koivo couldn't get it. Thornton does. Thornton trying to move into the middle. Can't get there. It's stood up by Salo. Salo, good play. Control that puck back in behind the net. Sakic from Lemieux and Brewer at 52 seconds. Riku Hall tied it from Lidman and Berg at 6:34. Scoring in that first. Swept back in by Lidman. And a quick putting back together. Sakic, Lemieux, and Aginla. Back out. Aginla tried to reach it. Couldn't get it. Played in behind the net. As they try and set it out in front, Ruutu got tied up. And taken down. Bounced off the side of the net. Brodeur reached for it. Couldn't get it. Great play by Ruutu in behind the net to keep things alive. Got help near side. Berg sends it back. Ruutu again is pinned up back there. Ruutu, number 15, is got the puck. Boy, is he working on this ship. At the point, sent back in by Ivy Berg. And right now, Team Canada needs an out. Without a stick, it is pushed away along the wall. Adam Foote trying to cover it up, couldn't in front. Shot just missed wide. And that was Ruutu.
What a great work shift by the Finns, getting it down low. Keep bound, keep bound. They're smaller than those Canadian defensemen, but they stay in there, stay in there. And a great scoring chance with persistence.
Tuomo Ruutu had the opportunity. He had 23 goals, 21 assists with the Chicago Blackhawks this past NHL season. Up the near side hip, and Hentonen, boy, he took a shot. Got it around the boards. Hentonen coming back to get it. Broken stick. Got chipped away and up by Scott Hannon. Hannon couldn't clear it far enough to get it out. Look at the physical play. Hagman, Nicholas Hagman, digging in. Number 9 in white. Finally taken away by Brad Richards. Rolled it out the center. Poke checked away from him. Finland had a clear little zone. A free out here, and they get it. Richards looks up the near side. Gagne. Gagne got pinned up. Get put on again. That was you-know-who, Nicholas Hagman.
Of all the games I've seen in the World Cup, this one most resembles an NHL game. And a game 7.
This is tough, isn't it?
Oh, baby.
I mean, they are hitting out there. Regeer will touch it up. And that's icing.
And by the way, we have 2 goals up on the scoreboard, 1 for each. A quick start for Team Canada. Lemieux fed Joe Sakic, and Canada was on the board, but the resilient Finns just keep playing. Lidman launched a shot that Riku Hall deflected. That's what we've got right now. And tons of hitting.
They get Kiprusoff doing the job at one end. Marty Brodeur at the other. Both have made tough saves in that first period. Cleared around by Salo. Sammy Salo plays for Vancouver. Could not move it out of the zone. Alarada tried. Doan hog ties him. Played by Koivu. Saku Koivu moved it up. Trying to go rink wide with it. Alarada, Mikko Alarada, 4 years in the NHL. And then he went back over to Europe to play in last season for Finland. Alarada takes the stand-up hit. Held in. Shot saved by Brodeur. Brodeur to knock that one away in the short side. Alarada got a backhander off. And that was close. Team Canada's got the odd man. Draper clears it, realizes he's got it, heads to the net. Shot on, score! A bad goal! And
You're not going to see this man, this kind of goal on Miikka Kiprusoff very often. A very weak shot from the outside, but a very heads-up play for Niedermayer to put it on the net, knowing that he had three guys going to the net. But amazing that Miikka couldn't handle this. You'll not see that very often from him.
And watch how he's moving here, too. He actually took a little shovel step, a little push off his left skate. Wayne Gretzky goes, yeah, baby, not the prettiest goal I've ever seen, but it may just be the biggest one in the last month.
Niedermayer gets the goal, his first of the World Cup. And it is a 2-1 lead for Team Canada. One of the game's outstanding defensemen, Niedermayer, scoring.
Almost looked like Kiprusoff didn't want to get all the way over to face Niedermayer, thinking that he was going to pass. I mean, he was on such a sharp angle.
Well, I'll tell you what, especially with Niedermayer coming out, he's almost like a fourth defenseman. He jumps up into the play so well. He controls the puck, and he's a great playmaker and a great shooter.
The Norris winner this past season in the National Hockey League as the league's number one defenseman gives Team Canada the second lead they've had in this game. They are up by a score. 2-1. Lennon bounced it off the near side wall, came back to center. Solani had to clear the zone. Timo Solani brings the puck in, or at least tries. It got picked up. Sakic, he gets it back. Solani looking, he is digging, dumped it. Lennon on. Brodeur, save! Cleared up and out of the zone. Marty Brodeur struggling a bit. Brodeur with that wrist that is hurt on the glove hand. He missed practice for a couple of days, came back in yesterday, tried it, and then back this morning, said, I'm all right, I'm ready to go in net.
I wouldn't expect to see him handle the puck very much, because that's the lower hand. That's the one that's going to be the tough one down lower on the stick.
I think you can tell the scouting report on Marty Brodeur is keep everything low, throw everything through the crease. The Finland team has really come out this game and thrown it at his feet, made sure they got the puck to the paint, because Marty doesn't like to move and get down that much, so they try to keep it near his feet as much as possible.
The goal scored by Niedermayer at 3:15. Draper and Thornton are credited with the assist, icing call here.
And this is kind of a bonus goal, I think, for Team Canada, because there's the checking line with Draper and with Doan and with Thornton out there that were up against Koivu.
But when
Niedermayer made it happen by jumping up.
Whenever you can get a goal out of your checking line, whenever you can get a goal from your checking line, whether it's your third line or fourth line, it's always a bonus, because you know you're going to get the points from Mario Lemieux, the Joe Sakic, the Jerome McGinley's. But when you get it from the Shane Doans and the Drapers and the Niedermayer stepping up that are playing on that line, it's just a big boost for your hockey club.
I think Shane Doan actually scoped out where the refs were before he grabbed that handful of jersey.
Got him down pretty good and got away with it, Shane Doan did.
As long as you know where the eyes are, you can do that sometimes.
Richards won the faceoff, gets it back. Martin St. Louis, his teammate, the intended, but it deflects up and into the netting for a whistle. So it's a 2-1 Canadian lead here.
This is not what the Finns want him to come out in this game in the second period here, is to fall behind, get this crowd back into it, because now they're going to start feeling good about themselves again. They're going to start clapping, they're going to start cheering soon, and I think the Canadians are going to feel it, and they're going to start keep coming at them.
Nobody said it was going to be easy.
No, nobody, and it isn't out there in this game. But JR is right, Miikka Kiprusoff, you won't see many of those. Kiprusoff and Brodeur came into this, the number one and two goaltenders, numbers-wise, in World Cup play, and really no surprise there. Back in behind the net, Vananen. Vananen gets tied up, takes a beating on the far side. Vinny LeCavalier working the body on him. LeCavalier takes Vananen down as the puck comes all the way near side. Sano will just lift that one up to get it out of the zone. Almeister played it ahead. Again, cleared by Vananen. Alaranta will dump that one in off the near side. Team Canada comes back. Right now, Team Finland out shooting Canada. 11-10 in the game. Down on the ice when Ryan Smith. That freed it up. Ruutu trying to drop it. Alaranta trying to send it into the middle. Vinny LeCavalier blocked it ahead for Heatley. LeCavalier trying to leave the ice off Kiprusoff's glove. And played by Aki Bird. Quickly trying to catch Team Canada in a change. They wave it off. Brodeur lets it go. Regier wasn't expecting that. He started skating backwards. Held in for that reason. Shot comes off the near side wall. Loose along the boards. Second chance. Ruutu. Had it, lost it. Alaranta hit, couldn't get to it. Berg and check. Richards cleared. Brad Richards got it out of there. Pretty good battle. And Berg going at it. Back the other way, it'll be dumped in. Jaco Ruutu from Vancouver centers it 2-on-1. Shot. Brodeur made the save on Yuri Lehtinen. Big save and a 2-on-1 down low. Martin St. Louis sends it in. Far side Gagne. Save made by Kiprusoff. A denied goal by Marty Brodeur. A look at it when we come back. All right.
favor of Team Canada. A little bit of time and space for the Finns. Brodeur keeps bringing up a good point, though. Brodeur is not down on the butterfly. He's the stand-up.
This is why teams say throw it at Marty's feet, because he doesn't want to go down that butterfly. I'd say 95% of the goaltenders are going to go down on their knees when that shot comes. But he stands up and just tries to get a piece of it. And I don't know if it's his old age, why he doesn't want to go down like that, or he's just tired, or that's his style. But I'll tell you what, whatever he's doing it right.
32 years old, huh? Oh, holy moly.
He's played a lot of games. He's worn.
Kiprusoff made the save on the dump in from that fireside point, as it was taken on the defensive chance that time by Eric Brewer. Cleared back out of the zone. Brewer has a goal. He got it against the Czech Republic. We've had just the second goal by a Canadian defenseman coming here in this game. That one cleared up. Niedermayer got it, of course, to make it 2-1. Chased back. And both teams will come over the boards. Timonen going in behind the net. 6-6 scoring chances in this final of the World Cup of Hockey. Finland and Canada. Canada's Mario Lemieux had it kicked away by Koivu. Clipped back into the zone. And Brewer coming back to get it. That's going to be whistled on the offside. Want to remind you, Saturday, ESPN brings you a special primetime college football doubleheader. It'll be the Fighting Irish taking on Michigan State, 7 Eastern. Then at 10, Heisman hopeful. Matt Leinart leads USC. They're number one against BYU. That's all coming up Saturday, ESPN. Off the faceoff, tic-tac at the center. Goal by Balmes to the other side. Salo sent Lemieux's pass right back out of the zone. Lemieux broke it up with a long reach. Lemieux got it back in behind the net. Kiprusoff didn't stop that. That almost came out in front. Lemieux centering. Again, like trying to line it up. Sakic got it. Sakic dodge. Shot deflected wide.
Broken stick for Finland is Salo.
Salo without a stick standing in front of his goaltender. Finland will avoid damage there as they're able to move it out of the zone. Finland back in the 3-on-3. That'll be high off the ball near side. Again, dumped it at center. Got away from Berg. Again, takes the hit. Flying around out there to Ruutu, number 15 in white. Lemieux flipped it away, just got it up away from Littman, who had to wait to try and clear the zone. Again, look, poke checked away by Berg, got it back.
Boy, they play again look tight, don't they? That's the Finnish style. They will not back up and let you come at them. They'd rather confront you on your side of the red line.
Two-line pass right there.
As a result, Jerome McGinley's been quiet. Twice in this last shift, he tried to get something going with the puck just outside his blue line, and he was confronted by a Finnish defenseman. Real aggressive, and not changing the way they play against Team Canada.
That's how your puck ends up in your own net, too. You start playing around the puck on your own blue line. Turnover, it's going to end up in your net. You better watch out.
Off the draw, it'll be won by Finland. A little set to Hagman, who's been flying around, getting into it with Niedermayer off that faceoff. Bounce back into the zone. Finland putting the heat on. Niedermayer ships it over. Finland backs up the center as soon as that happens. That's what they want to do, knock the pass away. Richards ended up with the puck going in on net. Center St. Louis. Richards shot, save. Kiprusoff not a lot on it. Regier, the defenseman, stepped up. It got batted off the wall. Regier quickly recovers. Gets back. Hagman. Niedermayer dropped it in the middle. Hagman will be a trailer here as he goes in behind the net. Regier got there first to play. Regier has been tough. Hagman trying to kick that one out front, couldn't get it there. Canada controlling. Brewer dumped it back into the middle. St. Louis, Richards out there on this line. Into the middle, Hagman again. Hagman looking, shot. Brodeur, oh, where it went. He looked to his left and went down to the five hole, and he made a save on it. Good play by Marty Brodeur off that deflection on the way in.
Exactly how Finland wants to play, though. We've talked about their aggressive play in the neutral zone, their great positioning. Their head coach, Raimo Suominen, I think, has done a tremendous job. Yeah, he's gotten his guys to hate him, but he's gotten them to play for him. Here was Brewer trying to get a play into the middle. They just ended up going to a Finnish stick. Aki Berg started the transition. And I know this was a deflected shot from just inside the blue line, but this is what happened when your passes, what happens when your passes misfire in the neutral zone against a team that is as well-positioned and as skilled as Finland.
Le Cavalier won the draw against Riku Hall. 2-1 lead, Team Canada. 10:53 to go. We're in period number two. Could be an icing. And no, good play. Ryan Smith got back there to avoid the whistle. Centered, it comes all the way back to the point. Baumeister will dump it back in behind the net. Le Cavalier using the backside to set that one up. Game to Elorada. Elorada trying to clear. It does finally roll out the center. Riku Hall was there, lost it. Finland back in their own end. He pressure on and a good check that ends up forcing the puck into the seats.
It's amazing to me watching Finland how they've evolved from being a real passive team, a real great skating team, to now being a physical team. And I think it's because of this guy right here. He is stressing to the guys, we need to play a North American game. If we're gonna beat Canada, we gotta beat them at their own game, playing strong, playing physical. And I think they're doing a good job of it tonight.
Ryan Mosuman, and of course, knows international hockey, also knows North American hockey. He played with both Kevin Lowe on the left and Wayne Gretzky on the right in 1984 with the Oilers when they won a Stanley Cup.
Played in both Edmonton and Vancouver, 83 through the 98th season. Back into the corner, Doan, got it away to Thornton, centering pass, ricochets around in the middle, but never ended up on net. Good setup made by Thornton, who sends it back again to the far side, Draper. Draper, Doan, Thornton with it, looking, nobody out in front. Thornton, wraparound chance, Kiprusoff reached up, broken stick, goes flying to the near side. Along to Team Canada's Doan, he was headed to the bench. Team Canada covers it well, let's whistle on the offside. Team Canada leading it, second period, 2-1.
Dan Brodeur says he has his Stanley Cup rings and all his trophies in a case at home, but it's the gold medal from the Winter Olympics in 2002 that everybody wants to touch, everybody wants to look at. He says that was the turning point in his career. It really opened a lot of people's eyes that people said, you know what, he did this without the Devils. And guys, you got to think that's what winning a World Cup would do for him as well.
It is such a big deal here. It is so hard to impress on fans in the United States what this game means. It is the game seven of the Stanley Cup playoff. I mean, this is what this is like. As JR said, it is the Super Bowl. Folks in Canada, it's the only thing being talked about.
Yeah, it's like a game seven of the Stanley Cup Finals or an Olympic gold game.
Lemieux drops it. Aginla backhanded it into the corner. Lemieux on the intercept, looking. Aginla cutting. Ooh, just missed. Stick in the ice. Tony Lindman blocked that, or Aginla would have had an empty net. Held in on the far side. Jokinen finally able to clear it out. And Jokinen dumps it off the wall for Ruutu. Ruutu pinned up immediately by Regier. Regier with that strong physical play got it away to Lemieux to Aginla. Lemieux trailing in the middle. Aginla pushes to the corner. He gets stood up by Timonen. Timonen has had an outstanding World Cup.
Well, I gotta tell you something. Jerome Aginla was stronger than that. Kimmo Timonen is able to overpower Jerome Aginla. Something's wrong.
Right back in by Timonen. Aginla going back to the bench.
And he just overpowered him and took the puck away from him.
Just don't see that. Timonen, of course, playing in Nashville last season. That'll be touched up on the icing call.
Well, the forerunner to the World Cup of hockey was, in fact, the Canada Cup. We will flash back to 1987. Canada against Russia. And Mario Lemieux, who had already established himself in the National Hockey League as an impact player, took another step in his development and helped Canada win it all in 1987.
Now trying to win it here, turnaround shot, save made by Kiprusoff on St. Louis.
What a save.
Flashing that right pad, Kiprusoff, who set an all-time modern-day mark this past regular season with a 169 goals against. He was magnificent in Calgary and stayed that way in the playoffs, one game shy of a cup.
But like I said, the guy has ice in his veins. He just doesn't seem like anything flusters him. That puck went in earlier in the period, and he just stood there and said, that's all right, I'm not gonna let another one go by. And it seems like he's got his confidence back right here, because he just made this really tough shot look very easy.
Oh, man.
God, is that quick.
I was talking to him while he was stretching in the locker room before the game against the U.S. a few days ago, and he was simply sitting there in a complete splits position. I mean, he's got flexibility, it's incredible.
Does that on the ice in the pregame warm-up. Still on one side. Salo put the hit on. Doan's in front. Trying to get it to him. Draper. Chris Draper from Detroit. Whistle. Penalty call down low.
Interference on Shane Doan. When you go to the net, you have to leave the defending player alone. He gives him a little shot to the back of the leg. And this was called by the outside line official. He has a whole view of the whole inside of the zone. And maybe the other guy was a little blocked out, but hey, good call. You cannot touch the defender in front of the net. You got to let him be here.
It's almost as if Shane Doan was due. Remember that handful of jersey that we saw about 10 minutes ago? He got away with that one, but not this one.
The call goes as a trip, 12:05. First penalty against Team Canada, only the second penalty that we have had in this game. So now Finland with a chance to get it tied up on a power play. They're 5 for 22, second best in World Cup play this year on the power play. Team Canada, though, is second best on the penalty kill. 1 for 15 against Team Canada shorthanded. That one is going to be cleared out of the zone. Aginla hanging, a great shorthanded score, Jerome Aginla. Move back into the zone. Great to have you with us, our Toyota World Cup of Hockey, ESPN2. This is the final. Canada's got the lead 2-1 second period, but a power play here. Ruutu in the corner, gets tied up. Jokinen over there was waiting, puck never got to him. Team Canada gets a free out right here, Adam Foote on the fly. And to the red line and in. Good job by Foote to get it down low. Brad Richards followed it up by being there. Down to 1:10 left to go on the power play for Finland. Move back out. Jokinen, 26 goals last year in Florida. Set it in. Marty Brodeur missed it. Nemo Solani comes up the wall to get it. Bounced away to the point. Nemo unable to hold it in. Yuri Lehtinen to the corner. He gets tied up by Niedermayer. Regier moves in to help out. Nemo Solani digging it out. Still a power play Finland. Solani, get that stick out of my face. Pump checked away. Good play, Niedermayer from behind. Short-handed. Into the zone and open. Gave it deflected way up off the glass. Simon Gagné. Gagné short-handed chance. 35 to go on the power play. Koivu. Saku Koivu will come back to get it. Koivu hog-tied at center. Return to him. Adam puts in front of him. Cuts him off. Down goes Koivu.
Does Adam Foote know how to separate people from the puck or what?
Salo had stepped way up so he couldn't hold that puck in. Solani's trying to clear the zone. Didn't. Foote went by and gave a little hit to the head of Saku Koivu. 12 on the power play for Finland. Still shorthanded Draper. Salo the hit. Ouch.
How'd that feel?
Touch in two and took a piece of the equipment off as well. 2 seconds left on the power play. Finland shot deflected by Brodeur up the left pad. Turnaround save! Rebound! Brodeur just had the stick down on the ice. And that was Hagman. They do not score in the power play. They do not get a shot on it. Power play over, and Canada has protected their 2-1 lead.
The NHL playoffs began. Very few casual hockey fans had ever even heard of Miikka Kiprusoff. By the time the playoffs had ended, he was a household name in Canada and in most hockey markets in the U.S. because the Calgary Flames rode his shoulders all the way to the Stanley Cup Finals, all the way to a Game 7, before giving way to the champion Tampa Bay Lightning.
And most importantly, that team, Calgary, they played as a team probably better than any team in the playoffs last year. And why? Because they have a lot of respect and a lot of confidence in Kiprusoff. You need a good goaltender in the playoffs to win, but you need one even better to get your team united and feeling good about themselves. He did that for them last year.
He's done that for Finland, too.
Yeah. He went 15-11 in the playoff year, had a 1.85 goals against and a 9.28 save percentage during the Stanley Cup playoffs last season. That'll be dumped in. A 2-1 lead for Team Canada. Finland in their white and blue in the zone. St. Louis avoided the hit. Hagman. Hagman has been all over the place. Dump back St. Louis. Clears it up Gagné. Gagné could not get the angle. Good play made by Newman. It'll cut him off. In front of the net. Now Richards goes behind it now. That's Hagman on him. A lot of room in that high slot area where Scott Hansen is trying to get set up. There goes Richards. No call. Fans wanted one. Elmeister held it in. Gagné, centering pass. Again, just chipped away by Teppo Numanen. And finally cleared out. Hannon will come back to get it. Scott Hannon out of San Jose, where he played last season. Dumps it back in behind the net. Aginla giving chase. Knocked away. Numanen. Numanen trying to clear it off the dasher. Right now, Finland got caught here in the line change. They're short of man. Short of man. Regier broke his stick. The blade came off on that shot. Kiprusoff reached. Makes a save and a rebound chance. Great play out in front. Joe Sakic the opportunity. What a flurry that was. Brodeur kicked it away. Hell back in behind the net now. Let's see if that'll fire him up after that defensive play and get a goal. Salo shot. Skimmed wide. From the point again. Just sent back in behind the net. Niedermayer trying to move it. Koivu overskated. Back up to the point. Held it again. Vananen. Vananen dumps it back in behind the net. Regier got there. He cleared it around. Salo's got it. His shot deflected. That came through a screen. And Brodeur, I don't think, didn't see it. Into the corner, Jokinen. Team Canada tied into the zone here. Niedermayer trying to clear it up, not out. Came with Solani. Turnaround chance got blocked in the skates of Niedermayer again into the middle and out.
A about Scott Niedermayer? He's 360ing himself into the ice, and he still has the presence of mind to look for an outlet pass all the way up to the center ice faceoff dot.
Just misconnecting. That'll be cleared out the length of the ice, and a touch-up will be made icing Tony Lidman back.
Well, you don't want to make a mistake if you're out on the ice against Mario Lemieux, and that's what Finland did. They got caught. There was seen a man way in the background. He's coming off the bench. If not for a busted stick by Robin Regeer, Canada would have generated an incredible scoring chance, and they ended up getting one on that rebounder. Kind of this rebound chance from Jerome McGinley anyway.
One thing that Mario does so well is he always gets the puck to the net. No matter where he is, he might just swing around and throw it blindly, but he wants everybody to go to the net, because if that puck's near it, it has a chance to go in. And he just threw that. Obviously went off a stick, but he tipped it over the net, and they had a good scoring chance. So I'm sure everybody's just conscious of going to net when Mario's on the ice.
Intended for Ryan Smith. That gets jammed in the corner. Berg cleared up, and it can't hold it in. Still loose. Hackman reached for it. Cleared back. Hackman's got it. Hackman trying to line up for a shot. Down on the ice behind the play. Ryan Smith of Team Canada just getting up. Number 94.
Go hit the face.
He is hurt and heading to the bench. Kiprusoff holds it up. The Cavalier charging in. Berg. Berg with Heatley on him up the wall for Hackman. Ryan Smith got to the bench where he will get some care as he got hit in the face. No, obviously no call of anything here. Played back on. Meister will touch that one up. Let's check in with David and Barry.
All right, Barry, last couple of minutes in the second period. Your Pat Quinn, how do you shake things up right now?
I don't think you have to shake things up. I think they're playing fine. They're winning the game. They're playing hard. You're going to have to give Finland some chances. They're a great hockey club. So, again, don't panic. Everything's fine, David.
And the All-Melrose team coming up in the second intermission. Guys, back to you.
Pretty good cut.
I'll tell you, this is the second time that Ryan Smith has been hit in the face. Earlier in the first period, you didn't see it, but he got
two saves. Rebound, Kiprusoff. Adam Foote, Doan, and Thornton down low. Two chances for Team Canada. Into the middle. Gets blocked into the corner. Good try by Thornton to center. Doan on to help. Thornton keeps the puck.
No stick for Koivu here.
Thornton a chance. Down low again. Bounced in behind the net. Brodeur has stepped up the defenseman. He's in front of the net. Eric Brodeur now moves back to the point. Sent back behind the net, so there was nobody there. Sakic and Niedermayer scoring the goals for Team Canada. Riku, Hahl for Finland. Sakic's now got four goals here in World Cup play. A 2-1 lead for Team Canada. Minute 59 to go. Kiprusoff knocked it down. Left it Salo. Lemieux read that. He went behind the net the other way. Mario Lemieux reaching in.
A little more ice time for him at the end of the second period, along with Joe Sakic.
Get him out there. Minute 46 left to go on it. Here's Ryan Niedermayer behind the net. Alarana was moving in. Cleared back up to the line. Gendler's on the right. Niedermayer the charge. Dumped it in. Kicked away. Sakic left it behind the net. Gendler got tied up again. Gendler was doing battle with Riku, Hahl. Lemieux was trying to get in front. They couldn't control the puck. Alarana in the middle. Left it instead for Hahl. And they'll dump. Alarana on the near side. Going back for Finland. He was the only one out there in the line change. Gendler knocked away by Berg, who just came out. Niedermayer clears it around. Cleared out. Hahl will play it. Riku, Hahl, Tony Lidman, brother, will play it. Back into the middle, Ruutu, Ruutu trying to move it in along the boards. Gagne couldn't cut him off. One, one. Oh! With a minute left to go, they tied it up. What a move!
Did you see that move on the on the boards? Did you see him get, was that Niedermayer that he beat? You can't beat Scott Niedermayer on the boards like that and make him look foolish. What an absolute beautiful, and then to beat Marty Brodeur with a beautiful wrist shot.
He has been one of Finland's, in my mind, two best players, two best forwards.
Oh, Tuomo, my Ruutu. Goodness.
What a goal.
Making Canada pay. The other one is Nicholas Hagman, numbers 9 and 15. Oh, baby.
Beautiful.
What a shot.
Wayne Gretzky's reaction. The head of Team Canada. This game is now tied at 2-2. 2-0 Ruutu played for Chicago, 23 goals, gets his first of the World Cup. How can he only have one goal?
I don't know, but Niedermayer's jock is sitting up here with us right now.
Get rid of him. Adam Foote, third and ahead, intended for Doan. Lost it, look out, Yuri Lehtinen guns it in. Game tied at 2-2 as the goal comes on the 19th shot of the game for Team Finland. So for the second time in this game, Finland has come back trailing 1-0, they tied it. 2-1, they tied it. And probably that's the way we're going to start the third. Jammed ahead. Thornton just got up, found it, kicked it into the zone. 27 seconds left to go in the period.
The one thing that we knew about Finland all along has really been evident in this game. You're never going to run away from them on the scoreboard.
They will not stop.
No.
They play that machine game. The goal at 19 minutes. Ruutu's first of the World Cup. Lidman the only one to get an assist on it. That's going to be whistled on the offside. So what a finish. We're going to have for you.
I think Scott Niedermayer jumped up thinking that Ruutu was going to get bogged down on the one-on-one along the boards. Well, Ruutu made a one-on-two look easy.
I don't see how Ruutu even saw Niedermayer coming. First, he had to jump out of the way from Gagne. Then he had the presence of mind to pull it in and just make Niedermayer look ridiculous there and then put it puck in the net. What a goal.
He danced, didn't he?
He danced. He strutted. He made it look bad.
So we have finished two periods in the final of the World Cup of Hockey. And what a finish we have for you. It's 2-2, Canada leading in shots, 21-19. But you will not see a prettier goal than this. 2-0 Ruutu, dancing once, dancing twice, creates a 2-on-1 down low end. Bingo! We're tied.
Canada wants to win this game. They obviously want to win it. They're at least going to have to match Finland physically. Finland was a tougher, more physical team that period.
Well, I think they surprised everybody by coming out and playing the style of hockey that usually Canada plays. And not only that, but they stayed so patient in that period, and they're just staying with them, and they're taking the crowd out. And because they're taking the crowd out, I think a lot of the Canadian players right now are getting a little frustrated.
Well, we saw Wayne Gretzky on the bench before the game biting his fingernails. Mario Lemieux used the word pressure. When we talked with him before the start of the game, you don't hear that from pro athletes very often.
But guess what? Finland is playing what we all feel is the biggest hockey game in the history of their country.
Yep.
And they don't seem like they're playing with any pressure at all. Mind you, it may be a little easier playing for this championship here as opposed to in Finland.
All right, we are underway. Third period, tied at 2-2. Finland in the blue and white team. Canada's in red shot. Kiprusoff and Brodeur, the two netminders. Adam Foote's coming up to hold the puck in. Knocked down was Doan. Doan has played a physical game. Doan's open. Doan!
How about that pass by Joe Thornton, Bill? What a little backhand chip by Joe Thornton behind the net. Little soft little chip. Shane Doan has a presence of mind to go to the net hard, and he's rewarded with a great patient goal, outweighted Kiprusoff and tuck it in the open net.
One of the keys to this hockey game will end up being, you got to think at this stage, the play of what really is a checking line. Here's Shane Doan and going all the way around Kiprusoff. That is the second goal for the Thornton, Draper, Doan line. They have scored two while keeping the Koivu, Solani, Lehtinen line off the board.
Shane Doan from Phoenix, 20-plus goals. Five consecutive years has given Team Canada the lead for the third time. They are up 3-2. Ellerott dropped off into the middle. Shot on Brodeur. That got deflected. Mario Lemieux. Lemieux turning it back the other way. Sakic in. Sakic trying to draw it back. And a shot at it blocked by Salo. Salo will tip it away. Letting it way up on the left side. Helton in over there as well. Back into the middle. Shot of Brodeur.
About Finland. How about the resilience of Team Finland? They come back with two scoring chances right away. Well, I'll tell you what, their resolve is cast iron. Their will is titanium. Marty Brodeur with a huge save.
Canada scored a goal in the first period at 52 seconds in by Sakic. They have scored a goal 34 seconds into the third period. Shane Doan, his first of World Cup action. Thornton and Foote get the assist, a 3-2 lead for Team Canada. Centered shot, Kiprusoff! He's got it underneath the pads and will finally get the whistle on St. Louis' chance.
Am I crazy? Am I the only guy here that thinks that Team Canada's going to need another goal to win this thing?
Nope, I agree.
I mean, Finland has not trailed by two goals ever in the World Cup of Hockey this year. Team Canada trying so hard to get this second one, or at least the second goal, to make it a two-goal lead. But Finland is just, watch out for them right now. They're coming back harder than they were playing before they got scored on.
It's the early part of the periods that have hurt them. Baumeister save made. Kiprusoff kicked it away. Richards got it back out in front. Shot Gagne on the blocker on the outside of the net. Gagne, Richards, St. Louis. Back onto the point. Bumister waiting, could not get to it. Look out, Hentonen. Hentonen moving it in, leaves it. Pass. Back near side, shot, missed the net. Artie Brodeur reached up, couldn't get it. Nico Kapanen was wide open for that shot, and he didn't get it on net.
Well, I'll tell you, Kinnunen just dodged the bullet right there. A great passing play. If he gets all of that, that's in the back of the net.
Kapanen shot it about a foot wide.
There is the problem you run into against a team like Finland when you go for blood. Team Canada desperately wanted to get that 2-goal lead, but when you overplay, you give up chances at your end. And therein lies the problem of having a killer instinct.
Hold in by Hahl, kicked away. Alarada couldn't hold it in. Back out the center. Donnie Lidman waits for him to clear. Lidman's played a fine game. Brodeur back to get it. Brodeur, big collision. Alarada, Brodeur, foot. Everybody was back there. Brodeur moves up the near side with it. Brodeur trying to clear the zone. He did not do it. Good play by Koivu to hold it in. Brodeur the other way. Alarada. Alarada puts the hit on. Down goes Alarada on the ice. He and Brian Smith. Smith got it against the wall. Alarada broke his blade trying to get it out of there. Smith won't let go of it and will finally get a whistle for a faceoff. Alarada was over there on top of Ryan Smith.
Gagne had a really good chance to give Canada the 2-goal lead, but see all three guys in red inside the faceoff dot. That would miss by about 8 inches. But because they were pressing, here came Finland on an odd man rush. Canada was thinking transition and didn't pick up the late guy coming Kapanen, and he just shot wide.
There you see, they have not trailed in a game in this World Cup. They are 5-0 in the tournament. Finland has had a 4-0-1 mark. Salo trying to shoot it in, lost it, trying to pin his man up, and the puck came free to Doan. Doan looking wide side. Salo off, moves it out. Salo will bring it up. Intercepted at center again. Pace picking up here in this third period. In Thornton looking, Thornton centered, and it blocked by Solani. On the back check, Solani, broken stick here. He let him save Kiprusoff, and he'll cover it up as he lost control of the stick.
Here's a perfect example of just getting the puck to the net again. He has a perfect opportunity to get the puck, maybe hit it short, hit it slow, and get it off his pads. He has Shane Doan going hard to the net. Obviously, Shane Doan's going to be there for a rebound. Put it on the net, let the goalie make a save, and have another chance at a rebound. But instead, he gets too cute. Chance nullified.
3-2 lead, Team Canada. That'll be cleared out of the zone. We are in the third period. This is the final of the World Cup of Hockey 2004. Great to have you with us. With Bill Clement, Jeremy Roenick, Aaron Andrews, I'm Gary Thorne here on ESPN2. Our coverage right through to the final here, and a whiz-bang third period. Great turn, Sakic. Sakic, backhander, save. Kiprusoff, he didn't know where it was. He still does it, and it's cleared to center. Move back up by Ruutu, dropped it into the middle. Trying to set it up for Koivu in front. Shot gets blocked off Jokinen's stick. Jokinen near side wall, doing battle with Mario Lemieux. Jokinen able to hold it in.
Kiprusoff didn't really care where the puck was. He just wanted to know where it wasn't.
Yeah, behind,
and that was
him.
Behind him.
He took a long look, glove floating out there on the ice being kicked around. You see the third period. Canada's up the ante. Move back in, Hintonen, and that's going to be whistled on the hand pass.
Excellent chance here by Joe Sakic. Mario Lemieux was playing blocker and jammer, and so was Jerome McGinley. Both Lemieux and McGinley sort of sealed up the front, so Joe Sakic came around and hoping for it to bounce out. Look at number 4, Thiemann, and the little guy against Lemieux. Had him completely tied up.
Come back in by Team Canada off the wall. Berg went over to get it, kicked in by Brad Richards. Lidman takes the hit from Gagne, squirts into Brodeur. Brodeur in the middle. Brodeur takes the shot, had it blocked.
I know what he did there. See, Finland's done such a fabulous job of getting in the shooting lane from the point men. They're trying to make a little fake, take a step to the left or right, and then get it by the legs.
That one's going to be whistled, hit with a high stick. 15-18 to go, third period. Mario Lemieux looking to wrap up this World Cup with yet another championship.
I think he's played more tonight than he has all in the last year and a half.
You're right. He's played so much that we have hardly seen Vincent Lecavalier this period. Hello, here. Right on cue, Vinny. Attaboy, you can take a cue. But this game, you know, won't end in regulation because Vincent Lecavalier has to score another overtime goal.
Thank you. Face off to the right side of Miikka Kiprusoff. Lecavalier will move in to take the draw against Yuri Lehtinen. Lettinen, three-time Selke winner, defensive forward. They'll whistle it, and they will do it again. You talk about four solid lines for Canada. Their lines are led by the Lemieux line with 14 points, but Le Cavalier line is 13. The checking line with Draper, they've got 12, and 10 for the so-called fourth line with Gagne, Richards, and St. Louis. I mean, that's some tremendous balance for Team Canada scoring here in this 2004 World Cup play.
How can you have the Hart Trophy winner from last season on the fourth line?
Amazing, isn't it? Wow. That one poked away and cleared up ice by Ryan Smith. Into the corner, loose. Smith came right back up ice, kicked away from Danny Heatley to the wall. Finland looking for the third time to come from behind and tie it up. Bouncing puck, Salo reached for it. Niedermayer got it ahead. Looking to Cavalier to Smith. Ryan Smith's shot wide to Kiprusoff. He let it go. Koivu. Saku Koivu from Montreal on the far side ahead to Alorada. Stayed onside, but he couldn't handle the puck. Both teams changing on the fly. Koivu get it up, trying to go into the zone. Davis Solani will send it in on the high flip. Niedermayer back to get it behind his own net. Niedermayer teamed up with Brodeur and will start it up ice. JR said he acts like an extra forward. Solani, they got a chance here. Skip through to the boards. Koivu centering. That deflects back near side. Boy, that was close. It got blocked. And Newman's chance never got through. Only one back. Back into the middle. Thornton reached for it. Doan got onside. Team Canada will change.
I think the Canadians are starting to get into a little lull right now. They're starting to play defense more. I think the United States learned that lesson the hard way by sitting back and trying to play defense. Finland kept coming. They ended up tying the game and winning it late. Canada's got to be very, very careful. They don't sit on their laurels. They go after them.
Sitting on your laurels oftentimes can hurt in places you don't like. Third period. Canada's on top of this by a score of 3-2. Doan, the go-ahead.
Brad Richards and Vincent LeCavalier, teammates from the Tampa Bay Lightning, but also very good friends. They grew up playing junior together. Brad Richards told me when he was named to Team Canada, there was a little tension in his relationship with Vinny because, as you know, Vinny was left out. Vinny LeCavalier goes to Brad Richards' golf tournament in the summer, and when he leaves, he gets the call from Wayne Gretzky that he will be on Team Canada. As soon as he got off the phone with Gretzky, Vincent called Brad Richards right away to let him know he'd see him at training camp, guys.
Boy, are they happy, Team Canada, that he's here.
Say, hey, we're buddies again.
Yep, we're okay. This is going to work. 13:34 left to go, third period. Team Canada leading Finland 3-2. This is the final of our World Cup 2004. Roar back in his own end, Team Canada. Mario Lemieux. Lemieux dumped it. Sakic for Aginla off the wall. Aginla reaching. Aginla. Okunen was on it. Okunen takes the puck away. Moves it back in behind the net. Aginla's going to stick in on him. Cleared back up by Aki Berg and out through center. Nobody back there to help out. Sent in the corner. Peltonen was giving chase. Peltonen trying to center. That got blocked. Cleared around the near side. Lemieux was back there on defense blocking that last chance. Salo cleared it into the middle. Team Canada trying to get a line change done. Brodeur sends it in and takes the hit. The hit from Ruutu.
Finland is trying to get back into this third period exactly how they did in the second period. They are just laying bodies on everybody.
Not missing any opportunity to finish a check. Or in this case, a Canadian. That is sent in offside. Couldn't help it. Saturday, ESPN's got a special doubleheader for you. College football, the Fighting Irish at Notre Dame, Michigan State, 7 o'clock Eastern. Then at 10 o'clock Eastern, number one USC and BYU, Saturday, ESPN.
On the game now, Finland is out-hitting Canada 28-19. But the biggest hits and the most appropriate hits have come when they wanted to change the momentum back to their side of the ice. And it worked.
Yeah, it has. Lettinen went it back in behind the net. Lettinen, Harry Lettinen, 26 along the wall. Had it once, got it again. Dumps it back into the corner. There is some banging going on out there right now. Turnaround shot gets blocked on the chance by Jukka Huttunen. Played off the far side. Look at the hitting going on. Temminen was over there that time. Into the middle shot. I think Brodeur got that. Marty Brodeur with an enormous save right there. Point blank range. Centering pass off the wall. Brodeur is going to glove this one and hang on. What an opportunity right there. Two of them for Team Finland.
You just can't knock Finland off the puck. I mean, Canada tried to lay the body on it to free up some pucks. Their puck movement is so good when they have a chance. Point blanker.
That's vintage European hockey right there. Little give and goes, especially around the net. Give and goes could obviously create such good scoring opportunities in the paint.
Anthony was down low on that. Last opportunity. Faceoff went back to the point by Koivu. Oh. Get Marty Brodeur, makes the save. Puck loose and clear. Sakic, Niedermayer, and Doan have picked up the goals. Team Canada. Draper on the intercept, moving it in. Riku, Hahl, and Ruutu have the goals for Finland. Scoring chances even here. Take it away and turn around. Niedermayer holds it in. Niedermayer getting back in behind the net. Going with Wyatt. 11:30 left here in the third period. Name is Solani. Solani held up by Doan. Weird around. Vanberg got it to Saiko Koivu. Koivu. Solani crisscross. In onside. Koivu pinned up right along the blue line. Backed in along the wall. Solani kicks it a little deeper. Vigier is there to move it in behind the net. Finland will change up. Vigier gets it back. Finland getting the new line back out on the ice. Found a little seam again.
That thing has some heat on it. Wow, did he get that away quick? What a great save by Kiprusoff.
Jerome again found a hole. Jokinen had a chance. Marty Brodeur holds the short side. Pelton in on the rebound in the corner. Adam Foote tied him up. Foote gets the puck. Clears it around, not out. Tebo Newman had dumped it right back. Aginla's on the far side. He's got Sakic in the middle. Aginla. Sakic a trailer. Comes near side instead. Backhanded in by Adam Foote. Trying to get to Sakic. Cleared around and into the middle. Foote. Foote drops it off to Brewer. Team Canada wants a change. He'll send it deep. Brewer back to get it. 28-24. Canada leading in shots and leading on the scoreboard 3-2. We close in on the midway point of this third period. Newman cleared it out of there. Yuri Lehtinen on the charge. Yuri Lehtinen into the corner. He got roughed up. Taken down by Scott Hannon. Almeister cleared it up to the point, but not out. Shot Berg. And another save made by Brodeur. A great finish. A one-goal game halfway through the third. Brodeur on the first shot of every period, Team Canada. There you see the first one. On a great setup, Mario Lemieux getting involved. Riku Hahl came back and then tied it up. Second period.
Second period, Miikka Kiprusoff wanted that one back, but he couldn't get it back. Then the Tuomo Ruutu show took over. A beautiful goal, 2-2 coming into the third. Shane Doan, a checker, not tonight.
The fans ready to celebrate here in Toronto. But 9:59 left to go. Sakic, Niedermayer, Doan, the goals. Thornton's picked up two assists so far. Doan comes over to get this. You saw Timonen have to make a defensive decision there and chose to back up and not move in. Solani trying to kick it into the zone. Couldn't get it through Brewer. Played by Tebo Newman, and Newman and added bounce. Draper will send that one into the zone. Kiprusoff coming back to play it. Finland. Continue to mention the biggest game in their hockey history as they try and win their first World Cup. Everybody in Finland up in the early morning hours to watch this game.
Well, if Finland's going to have any chance, they have to get Sakic, Koivu, and Timo Solani back on the ball here. They have to start being a power to dominate. Right now, they're invisible.
Let's take a look. And our summary brought to you by Samuel Adams, our World Cup summary. Marty Brodeur, 119 saves on under 24 shots to this point. Finland, the only team to overcome a deficit in this World Cup year. Can they do it again? Did not have the lead in this game. Team Canada's on top for the third time. Lemieux got taken out of the play by Salo. Team Canada will get it back at center. We close in on the 9-minute mark to go. Regier, Lemieux. Sends it in wide. Vananen. Vananen got checked from behind by Aginla. The puck came free. Jokinen will send it back into the corner. Peltonen. Peltonen turns on Niedermayer. Regier there up the wall. Held in by Lidman. And he lost it to Lemieux. Lemieux had a couple of nice plays with that long stick here. Kiprusoff and Aginla's chance. Kicked it away. Ruutu will pick it back up. Both teams changing. Into the middle, intercepted Sakic, and they have not cleared the zone.
I think Team Canada was listening to you, JR. I mean, they're really putting a strong forecheck on when they can, being responsible with their second man in, their third man in, and Finland has not been able to get anything going here for about the last 4 or 5 minutes.
Well, during one of those last breaks, I looked at the bench and I saw Ken Hitchcock yelling at some of the players, saying, "Let's go at them, guys, we're sitting back. Didn't we learn from what happened to the U.S. the other day? Let's go."
That'll be whistled on the offside again. Faceoff back out at center. Mario Lemieux taking the glove off over there, as though he may have taken a whack. That left hand.
Well, if there's no ice on it, that's a good sign for Mario.
Captain here of this Team Canada. He did not get to play in 96 when the United States had the upset over Team Canada. Team Canada's trying to just wrap them all up now, having won the gold in the Olympics in Salt Lake, looking for the World Cup championship here, reestablishing themselves as the world's best. Deep it goes. Timonen pays the price. Sakic was all over. Bounced up in the air. No more pressure put on. Finland had it at center, knocked away by Richards. They've got the regroup. Timonen is from playing with Nashville. Sends it back in. Marty Brodeur up. Holmes first got it. Let it go all the way through center. Ryan Smith will poke it into the zone and made sure he didn't get a whistle on it. Both teams again changing, trying to keep fresh lines out there. Edelman trying to move that one in, could not. Tied up at the blue line. Team Canada standing him up at the blue line that time. That'll be sent in by Heatley. Le Cavalier sends it back in behind the net. Antonin, he played for Switzerland during the regular European season. Antonin did, and of course, playing here on the Finnish national team. That one will be sent in from center. Ruutu got it in deep. Team Canada and Finland over the boards. And they'll wait. Teppo Nieminen in behind the net.
Again, the matchup that Pat Quinn has stuck with since the opening faceoff in place. Joe Thornton with his guys Dolan Draper against Saku Koivu, Teemu Selanne, and Juri Lehtinen. And they have done a tremendous job of negating the most dangerous offensive players from Finland.
They dump it in deep to try and get it off. Oh, my Christ, just got it. Mikko Eloranta down on the ice. Eloranta got leveled. He's moving out there. There's no whistle yet. He gets back up. Not sure he knows where he is. They've got to clear the zone. Draper steals it. 3-on-2. Draper moving it in. Blast is held onto by Kiprusoff. Mikko Eloranta getting to the bench.
Well, in the National Hockey League, we stress work. Work hard. Try to negate the icing. Let me tell you something. This takes a lot of guts to go in there first, knowing that you're just going to get killed. Listen to this.
Hit by Robin Regier. And Robin Regier. And here's with Eloranta knew going in, that he was going in against Robin Regier. Robin finishes everybody and everything.
Joe Sakic on the faceoff trying to get it back after Jokinen won the draw. That'll be dumped. Brewer trying to get it, could not. Played back in behind the net. Brewer down to 6:11 left to go. The clock is all screwed up here, so we can't tell you. I think the clock's still running. It was blinking on and off. Now it's back on at 6:04 remaining to go. Played back in behind the net by Vananen. Moved back by Salo. Salo, Team Finland trying to get back into it. That'll be deflected up and over the glass. Canada leading it by a score of 3-2. 5:52 left, and it is not over.
Well, this may be the last hockey we see for a while. Maybe the last hockey we see for a long while. But as usual, it's been a tremendous tournament. Wayne Gretzky, having built the second team. Remember, Canada won gold in 2002 at the Olympics. Only 10 players are holdovers from that team 2 years ago. So a changing of the guard with some exceptions. Here's one, Mario Lemieux. Canada still poised to flex their muscles as the world hockey power.
This is one reason. Well, we have to get this labor issue resolved and get back to playing. With Mario feeling as good as he is, getting back into shape, playing some of the best hockey he's played in years, we need to be on the ice and have the talents of Mario Lemieux on TV to help boost up the hockey in America. Because now we have Mario back, we need the hockey back. We got to get this thing straightened out.
All these young players, realize 12 of the 25 on this Canadian roster are under 25 years of age. I mean, this is a young Canadian team. 12 are 25 or younger. And you got got that great mix of the Sakic, Lemieux type veterans on this, and then all these young kids who are learning from them. And you don't play hockey this year, what effect will it have on the Tampa Bay franchise that wins the cup, rights itself, gathers a huge momentum there in Florida?
Forget the momentum.
It'll all be gone.
All be gone.
Not only that, but now they have a good fan base down there. They've created excitement. They've brought people in. They've given them a championship team. People are excited about it. And now you're going to sweep it right out from underneath their feet. It's terrible.
There will be tomorrow, as we said, the press conference in New York. The players will be locked out. Tomorrow afternoon, the announcement will be made. And then nobody, and I mean nobody, knows where it goes from there.
Well, for all the people that are the folks out there that actually pay the salaries and create the profit for the owners by buying hockey tickets, we're sorry, folks. We're damn sorry.
And not a thing we can do. Brodeur goes back to get it. Laid it back in behind the net. 5:46 left to go here in this third period. Can Finland come on with one big goal to get this thing tied up in this third? Again, in the corner. Takes the hit, Jokinen, Aginla controls it. Aginla, Jokinen do battle along the near side wall. Jerome Aginla backs it up, Lemieux back out, leaves it on the point, Brodeur to Lemieux. Lemieux looking, Sakic's out there in front of the net, comes back to help. Sakic trying to kick it away, could not. Puck sitting there, Aginla, Jokinen just would not let him go.
Jerome Aginla's best shift of this game, though. He killed about 35 seconds off the clock by himself.
Niedermayer gets it, jams it right back in. Team Canada and Finland will change it up. 5 minutes to go, third period. Played back in behind the net. Cleared up by Littman. Nobody there but Foot. Adam Foot. Foot flips it. Lost it. Foot recovered enough to keep Finland from getting it in. Littman sends it in, intended for Tamu Solani. Played by Marty Brodeur. Brodeur round off the dasher. Littman stepped up. Littman intercepted. What a game Littman has played. Salo back to get it.
He's got primary assists on both of Finland's goals.
Doan stripped to the puck of the blue line. Koivu to Tamu Solani. Back to Koivu. Foot's there in front of him. Foot and Brewer out there defensively against this top line for the Finns. That'll be sent in by Thornton. Making sure Team Canada that they get the puck deep and then get a line change to keep fresh legs out there. Finland now is going to make the charge.
It's time to take some chances now for Finland. They played a very aggressive forechecking defensive style. Now it's time to send everybody. Take a chance. Go for that goal. They need 4 minutes left. They have to start taking as many chances as they can.
Marty Brodeur to knock it down. Hantanen was the man who tried to knock it into the net.
Well, Canada has participated in every final game in the Canada Cup, the forerunner to the World Cup of Hockey and the World Cup. But one thing Canada has never done, no team has ever won every game in a Canada Cup or a World Cup. The best record was Canada's 6-0-2, but they are 4 minutes and 7 seconds away from going undefeated, wire to wire.
They have won 7 straight games that have been decided by a goal, and Brodeur with a big save. Tevinen, blue line chance, and that was an opportunity.
Now, Marty Brodeur, you knew that he didn't want to squeeze the puck and take a faceoff here, because you always stand a chance of losing it. Look at the Finns, they just clustered around. All three forwards had a part in that faceoff win. But because they were all trying to win the faceoff back to the blue line, there was nobody screening.
Riku Hahl moves in to take the draw. They'll whistle it. 35-27, Canada the advantage on faceoff so far. Big one right here, and Joe Sakic won it. Wallmeister sends it around, Lemieux waiting. Teppo Newman and all over him. Lemieux just fed it off the wall. Will they get it out of there? Yes, they will.
Or Joe Sakic. I don't think I've ever seen him make a mistake on one of those little dump outs of the zone, even when he's deep. What a touch he has.
He is an amazing player. 91 for Canada, and he's still out there. Wallmeister all the way up ice. Wallmeister into the corner. Gets tied up by Littman. Sakic, Lemieux, shot, fanned on, Niedermayer. 3:30 left to go, third period. Final game, World Cup. Canada trying to wrap it up and remain undefeated. Finland has come back twice, trying to do it again. Into the corner, Hagman, who has played a tough game. Trying to get it to the point, Salo jammed it off the wall and helped to hold it in, but it's bounced away off Richard's stick. Brad Richards gets it back 3-on-2 into the middle. Looking, Gagne shots, rebound, save by Kiprusoff. 8-3 on two with St. Louis with a second chance after Gagne had the first. Kick back to Martin. St. Louis by Richards into the middle. Gagne blocked. Richards again shot. Side! Kiprusoff, and he had St. Louis skating right in front of him.
Remember those two saves right there.
Big saves by Miikka Kiprusoff. Gagne clears it in.
Here comes the crowd. They can sense it now with 2.5 minutes left. They know that cup is in sight, and they don't want their team to get a letdown. They're going to start getting loud.
Johnny Lidman played it off the wall. It'll be held back in by Doan. Back to get it is Lidman. Lidman challenged by Draper. Holds it. Goes to Teemu Selänne. Selänne looking up ice, trying to send it in. Missed it. Doan got it back. Doan ships it ahead along the near side wall. Team Canada stays onside. The dump in by Thornton rink wide. 2:11 left to go. Berg going over to get it. Berg sends it to Selänne. Name is Selänne. Hoivu. Hoivu to the red. Hoivu into the zone onside. Team Canada will not getting room. Brewer just dumped Hoivu at the blue line. There to Randall Lemieux. Mario Lemieux. Off the wall. Not out. Kevo Newman and held it in. Lemieux sends it deeper into his own zone to Brewer. Minute 47 left to go. Up the near side boards, not out of there. We'll keep an eye on Kiprusoff at the other end with a minute 40 remaining here in the third period. Tevo Numminen. Numminen bounced it in. Brodeur's got to play it. And Foot clears it around. There will be an all-tourney team and an MVP. That one goes up into the netting. A minute 29 left.
We have talked about how you can't bury the Finns. You can get them in the grave, but it's tough to start throwing dirt on top of them. Why? Because of the play of their goaltender, Miikka Kiprusoff. A screen that came through St. Louis off the stick of Brad Richards. Before that, Simon Gagne with a drive from the slot. And Miikka Kiprusoff digging in. A minute 29 seconds to go. Finland appears to have called the timeout here.
It's exactly what you want from your goaltender, to make that big save. To keep them in range, give them that opportunity to tie this game up, because it could have ended right there. What are some great saves by Miikka Kiprusoff.
Toronto's full house waiting,
and this is in a minute and 29 seconds. Should Canada hang on to win this, the coming of age of the young players will just about be complete, especially the defensemen for Team Canada. I know they've got Mario Lemieux on the bench. They've got Jay Bouwmeester. They got the Florida Panthers. They got Scott Hannon of the San Jose Sharks. They got Eric Brewer, the Edmonton Oilers. These are all young players that have done a tremendous job so far in the World Cup. A minute 29 seconds from now, their development will be just about complete if they're champions here.
Interesting what they've done here. None of the banners that normally hang from the ceiling were hanging in this game until 1 minute ago. They dropped all the banners, all the championship banners, all the Hall of Fame members and retired numbers here in Toronto, the Canadian flag. All of this just came down out of the rafters. There was no appearance of them until like 2 minutes ago. All the Stanley Cups that have been won, carry on the tradition, was the sign inside the Canadian locker room for this game tonight. Boy, they're playing this one right into the film festival that's going on here. Brodeur clears this one back out to center. Minute 23 left to go. Sakic on the intercept. If Lemieux was ever to get a goal here at the end of this game, all those banners might come down due to noise abatement. Into the corner, Team Canada trying to control Finland. Empty net at the other end. They got the extra skater. Salo shot. Brodeur knocked it away. Hit it with a blocker. 1 minute left to go, third period. Niedermayer. Salo. Salo trying to jam it out. Niedermayer trying to tie it up. Salo comes all the way down into the corner to help Ruutu. Behind the net, centering pass blocked by Agenla. Empty net the other way. Agenla just flips it out of there.
What a very smart play by Agenla. Never has the puck in the last minute. Unselfish, he just chips it away.
Jokinen's got it. Jokinen trying to move by. Can't. Thornton clears it back into the zone. 32 seconds left to go. Team Canada on the verge of a World Cup championship. Up the near side wall. Finland can't get it out of there. Centering pass by Doan gets blocked. 18 seconds left to go. Canada's game, Canada's heritage. They lost the World Cup in 96 in the best of three to Team USA. Can they get it back tonight? Hoivu knocks it down. Hoivu in the corner doing battle with Hannah. Hannah, Gagne. 3, 2, 1, the championship! Canada!
hockey. They never trailed him. How solid is that?
A perfect mark. First team in World Cup or Canada Cup history to win every game it played in a single tournament year.
Well, you could feel the excitement up here all week, being here, knowing that their championship is right at their fingertips. And I'm telling you, that's all Canada wanted is a championship. International play especially, Stanley Cups and all, but international play is so important to Canadians. They take this so seriously. This is bigger than the Super Bowl up here in Canada, and now they got it.
Mario Lemieux, Marty Brodeur, the winning goaltender, questionable until really last night as to whether or not that wrist would hold up so he could play.
Well, what an effort for Team Finland. This is the team, the best team that Finland has ever had. And it starts with their goalie, Miikka Kiprusoff. And they really believed that they could beat anybody, and they came within a goal of tying Canada here in the championship game. They have a lot to be proud of.
So Finland and Team Canada go through the traditional handshake that we see in the Stanley Cup playoffs and in World Championship play. And Finland will have to wait. They won the silver in 92 at the Olympics, the bronze in 94 and 98. They were hoping for their first world championship here, but by one goal, Miikka Kiprusoff and Team Finland lose to Canada 3-2. Canada now has won 8 straight games decided by one goal. Games decided by one goal, not that they were all consecutive, but the last 8 games they've played in that were decided by one goal, they have won them all.
And you know what? I can't think of one player that played for Canada in the World Cup of Hockey that didn't contribute in some way. You look at the offensive numbers, if you think about the players that were the defensive unsung heroes, Roberto Luongo comes in and wins the game Saturday night that brings them into the championship game. I'll tell you what, team all the way.
Aaron Andrews is on the ice, Aaron.
All right, Gary, here with Martin Brodeur. You've got the Stanley Cup rings, you have the trophies, you have the gold medal. Where does this rank?
Well, this is great, you know, just knowing that we had a chance to win it, you know, a few years back in 96, and now we come in here and dominate throughout the tournament, being 6-0, definitely a great feeling.
How much more does this mean to you because you were the number one guy coming in?
Well, it's a lot of pressure, but, you know, I've been playing with some great players over there, and they really helped me out, you know, my injury. When Niedermayer, Roberto was able to jump in there, still a big game for us, and was the opportunity to play in the finals.
How bad was the injury for you, Marty?
Well, you know, it was pretty tough for me not to play. It was definitely hurting me, but today, trainers did a good job, and I was able to play.
Martin, thanks so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, guys, back over to you.
Aaron, thanks very much. There will be an MVP, as we said, as well as an all-tourney team here, and as Bill noted, tough to select 13 different goal scorers for Team Canada. The all-tournament team is also going to be announced here. Here they are. The goaltender from Team Canada, Martin Brodeur. The remaining members of this all-tourney team. Let's go to the PA announcer for it.
On defense, from Team Finland, Kimmo Tiininen. And from Team Canada, Adam Foote. And the forwards, from Team Finland, Saku Koivu. From Team Canada, Vincent Lecavalier. And from Team Sweden, Fredrik Modin. Samsung High Definition Pedestal TV with DLP. please join us in congratulating Team Canada's Vincent Le Cavalier, our Samsung Tournament MVP.
How's that for a guy who wasn't supposed to be on this team, but for an injury, ends up being the MVP on the championship team?
Well, it's funny because we talked earlier how Vincent LeCavalier's development in this tournament almost mirrors how Mario was back in 86. To come in, to be a replacement, and to be the MVP just goes to show you the talent that Vincent LeCavalier has.
Somewhere, and I'm going to assume it's in Tampa Bay, John Tortorella is smiling, as he should be.
Coach of Tampa Bay, who had his battles with Vinny LeCavalier to try and make him a better player, team player.
Torts, we know you're watching,
yeah,
and we know you're smiling right now.
Boy, I'll tell you, how about that? 99 days after you won a Stanley Cup, you win the World Cup of hockey, and you're the MVP of it.
Marty St. Louis won the Hart Trophy for Tampa as the MVP in the regular season. Brad Richards won the Conn Smythe Trophy as the MVP in the playoffs. And now Vinny LeCavalier wins the MVP of the World Cup.
Mercy.
Dynasty.
Coach of the Year. Tampa Bay.
Yep.
Man, oh man.
I'll tell you, I think Team Canada did a great job in picking this team. It was great. I think they picked a team that most resembled an NHL team, especially on an NHL ice, to go out there to dominate all the world like they did. It was impressive.
Let's go back down to Aaron.
All right, Gary, I'm here right now with Vincent LeCavalier, named MVP. What's going through your mind right now, Vinny?
Well, it's a great honor. I mean, it's definitely a team effort. We played so well throughout the whole tournament, not losing a game, and playing with Smitty and Danny Heatley was unbelievable.
Well deserved. Congratulations, Vinny.
Thank you.
All right, guys, back up to you.
Aaron, thank you. He's going to go back over and join his team as the presentation now. Gloria Salmon is going to make the presentation. One of the great Toronto favorites back for this. And Mario Lemieux will accept the award.
This is what Mario worked so hard for this summer, to get himself in shape, get himself the ability to play at the level that he played in to win this cup for Canada. He was awesome.
Sure set a tone early.
And you called it. What a great call. Not that it was very hard, but Mario Lemieux. That was awesome. Right off the start, he heard you.
Frank Gehry designed that, an architect for a new World Cup. And Mario Lemieux, you saw him signal, he wanted the rest of his teammates out there, and now he'll take it around.
That's going to be on the front page of the paper tomorrow, guaranteed. Take a look at that shot. All over Canada, front page.
As long as it will hold champagne, it qualifies as a quality trophy.
Well, it's funny, because we talked about the trophy, and this is a new trophy this year now. They said the last trophy that they had, that the Americans won in 96, the players complained because it was too heavy. They had to carry it around and they couldn't carry it that long. So they had to redesign it.
Team Canada celebrating. Well, guys, it's been a pleasure working with you. I hope that God we have hockey soon, but only the good Lord knows. So for Aaron, JR, Bill Clement, Gary Thorne, let's go back to Dave and Barry.
Guys, a great job of calling this entire tournament that started a couple weeks ago in Helsinki. For those of you, a little programming note right now, NFL Live will not be seen tonight. Baseball tonight is coming your way. We will show you Barry Bonds chasing his 700th home run. We will show you his at-bats live with Carl Ravitch, Harold Reynolds, and John Kruk in just a moment. I know you want to talk, so we got your post-tournament thoughts coming your way in just a sec. Keep it locked right here on ESPN2. More from the World Cup of Hockey coming your way. Canada, a champion yet again.